while since I've been to a chamber meeting. I used to be on the board, and I don't recall the conversations being this lively. So 6, 7, 8 years ago, I haven't realized what I was missing.
Hang on, don't get worse.
Your topic of donations this morning earlier is very timely, and so I'm here to talk about donations. I'm not here to talk about donations from the chamber. So I want to share a good news story that I think everybody, I would hope, can relate with, because it talks about building the economy and quality of life of Nova Scotia, building that economy and quality of life of Lunenburg County and of Bridgewater proper. We have engaged in a campaign, a capital campaign. This is our first for Nova Scotia Community College. And we're very proud to set out. It is called Make Way. And there is a handout for you to follow along. I'm not going to go through every slide, but if you certainly, Mr. Lipset can speak to some of this as well. And so I just want to take a little time, just do a high-level overview. Would really want and be encouraged to engage in a conversation with you at some point if you were to learn more. Just want to talk about a little bit about the background of Make Way, where it started and where we are to date. For those of you who may not have a strong understanding of Lunenburg Campus, give you a little bit of an update on Lunenburg Campus, as well as our Make Way campaign to date and what we're trying to do. And then my ask of the chamber, how can you help, how can you support us? We have three objectives for the campaign. So the campaign is a provincial campaign. So all of the communities that have an NSCC campus are engaged in campaign, as well as provincially in scope as well. So we have three objectives. One is to build our brand to our external audience. So for some of you who are very aware of what we do at Nova Scotia Community College, that is great. But there's also a lot of people who are not quite familiar with what we do. So we want to provide that opportunity to engage in that conversation, throw our doors open, invite people to come and have a tour, look around. For those of you who drive up on High Street, you may have noticed over the last 8 months we have been engaged in a significant construction project, renovation project. For those of you who've been inside the building previous to the renovation, some of the innovative and creative things that we're doing in that building were not necessarily evident by the exterior. So the exterior of the building is fairly old. We're going on 50 years in 2019, so we have deep roots in our community. So this is the first significant significant investment that we've had in the college exterior. So it was a 5.1 funding between the province and the federal government through the Strategic Investment Fund. Our second is to develop a culture of philanthropy within the college and within our communities. You will be not surprised for those of you who attended post-secondary other than NSCC, to know that our sister institutions, our university system, have a long history of philanthropy, of doing capital campaigns for the development and evolution of their buildings. This is the first time that NSCC has embarked on that, so it's going to take a little bit of time to get people's heads turned around to why we need to do this and why we want to do that. And then our third goal is we've set an ambitious goal of $25 million provincially. We are well on the way. We have about $22 million right now, and I'll talk a little bit about that buffer to get to that $25 million goal, or to exceed that $25 million goal. One of the slides showed you some of our major sponsors and donations and donors to date. These are donations that are actually cash. We also have other avenues for donation as well, and I'll talk about that. Our two pivotal donations have been from the Ron Joyce Foundation, which really kicked off our campaign about 18 months ago, giving $4.6 million. And most recently, probably about 3 months ago, the Sobey family and the Sobey Foundation gave an astounding $6.5 million. These monies will be used at all of our campuses, and so the students at Lunenburg campus will and can benefit from those generous donations as well. And there are a number of others, Trevor, I'll just bring your attention to. Michelin have been very, very supportive of NSCC, not only in Bridgewater, but at the other two locations. And we've engaged with that partner as well. Want to just share with you the little bit of history of Lunenburg campus. As I mentioned earlier, we opened our doors in 1969 in September, so we're coming up on 50 years. In the mid-80s, the Nova Scotia Community College was formed, where all of the vocational schools in the province, there was some contraction, but they came together under that banner of Nova Scotia Community College. And then a pivotal moment for us was in 1996 when we became board governed. So being able to chart our path where we thought and where we think that Nova Scotia Community College needs to go to support our communities. In 2005, the province had made a significant investment in the college of $123 million. And you would have seen the front of the building, we call it the bump, where our student services, our business office are located, and that was about $1 million investment in the campus at that time. As I mentioned, 2016, we were lucky enough to have a curtain wall project announcement made, and we're probably 95-98% completed now, so we had to have that by the end of March. Over 50 years, we've been able to reach into our communities, reach into the families of our area, and we estimate we have over 8,500 graduates that have come through the doors of the Lunenburg Regional Vocational School and NSCC Lunenburg campus. So we have a strong history with a lot of people who have come through our doors, and it's very rare that at any event that I'm in, when I ask people, have you been associated? Are you associated? Have you graduated from one of these institutions? There's always a few hands that go up. Currently, we have 16 programs. We're always looking to make sure that our programs are staying relevant for along two lines. Industry needs. We need to make sure that we are responsive to industry. And also, in our area, we look to serve our industry in our area. Our students who come to Lunenburg campus, for the most part, one stay in our region, and we serve as Lunenburg County and Queens County. So we want to make sure that we have job opportunities and the potential for them to stay, start a family, and raise their children in this area. In addition to what we call our core programs, those 16 programs, we also have the opportunity to offer continuing education courses, as well as customized training. When a business has a specific learning need, we can certainly work with them to build a model of a program or a course that can give them skills to make sure that their skills, their workforce is up to what they need it to be. For Lunenburg campus, we have created an internal-external committee. So we have a campus campaign committee with combination of internal individuals as well as external. Michelle Krause is my co-chair, and she's been a great community member in various capacities, and many of you might be familiar with Michelle. We have set our goal at $350,000 for Lunenburg campus under three areas. One is student aid. And these would be awards that would be based on financial need, as well as emergency funds for students in crisis. We have a situation in Lunenburg County and Queens County, because those are the two counties that we primarily serve, where we have a lot of people that are wanting to come to NSCC. The biggest barrier that they face is financial. And we want to, and we feel we have an obligation, because our province needs every person who can be engaged in the workforce to give them training to get them to that position where they can come into one of your businesses or one of the businesses in our communities to do good work on their behalf. When a student does come to NSCC, and it could be any of the campuses, sometimes their window is very small. Their window for success is very small. And we find from time to time that their path, they're very focused academically, they can do the work, but sometimes they don't have all the financial resources at their disposal that would allow them to to be entirely successful. Some of our students work full-time jobs. Some come right out of high school. Some are single-family moms, parents who have significant responsibilities in their life. And we're trying to make sure that from that recent high school grad to that 35-year-old person who wants to change his or her life, they have family commitments, they might have parental commitments as well. We've run into situations where students will come to our student services department and say, I need to withdraw. It's always a little bit of a stark moment when somebody comes and says, because you get a little bit of a lump in your throat thinking, oh my goodness, they don't like their program, there's something the matter, they don't like NSCC. And sometimes that is true. I'll try to paint that kind of picture. But sometimes it's because they have an unexpected expense. They have a car repair that's unexpected, that prevents them, based upon the previous conversation, they're outside of town. And without that vehicle, without that mode of transportation, they cannot continue. Those expenses are not high. Those repairs are not large amounts of money. They might be $50, $100, $200 or $300. But to that individual, that is a deal breaker for them. So we want to provide opportunities, and we do provide opportunities where we help students get over that hurdle. They resolve that issue, and then they go back to focusing on their learning, and we end up having a wonderful situation where they cross the stage and graduate. So we're so pleased with that. We also want to allocate some of our capital campaign toward innovative programming spaces. Student wellness is a huge focus for Nova Scotia Community College. Mental health initiatives, as well as extraordinary learning opportunities. Each year we have students who take the skills that they're learning and want to work internationally under our NSCC International banner that can actually make a difference in a developing country or an area that's less fortunate than us. So it might be a refrigeration student who's going and doing some work in an area that could use those types of skills where they might not have that access to that reliable skill set. Of the priorities, the third one is instructional equipment. We want to make sure that we always have a cutting-edge learning environment for our students. And this is where some of those pieces of equipment are quite significant in cost. And a lot of times we have to make some hard decisions. And I'll look at Blair and say, Blair has to make those decisions with some of his team. I just want to pick up on that theme in a moment. One of the things that I'm sharing when I'm going around speaking to various groups and individuals is that the Lunenburg Campus campaign is local. Each dollar that we raise for this campaign in Lunenburg and Queens Counties will remain at Lunenburg Campus. While we do have an NSCC foundation, they are the stewards of all those gifts and all of those donations that are made. We do not take any administrative fees out of those. So if it's $100 that you donate, it's $100 that goes to whatever that donor determines that their gift will go towards. So it's a 100% fee, no administration fees taken off. I want to talk a little bit about who we're looking to engage in this journey with us. And certainly our industry partners are first and foremost. We think we have a symbiotic relationship where they're hiring our grads, we're fulfilling a requirement that they need of labor, and we think that's a very positive relationship. That support can be financial. So as I said, it can be cash. It can be a one-time cash or a one-time donation. It can be an endowment. So an endowment would be a significant amount of money that would be invested, and then in perpetuity, we would be able to draw from that and give awards to students. That might be a student sponsorship, and that's looking at Trevor directly. Michelin has engaged in that avenue where they will identify students, they will support them, provide support to tuition, but also provide working opportunities during the year. And then some of them could be multi-year. So an organization might say, we'll donate $10,000, but it'll be a $2,000 donation for 5 years. So we can work that as well. But for our industry partners, and back to having a cutting-edge learning environment, it's also the in-kind donations. So it's those engines, it's those pieces of equipment, it's that software that can be very cost prohibitive, and when we have strong industry relationships, they will step up and say, we will give you a diesel engine that typically might cost $25,000. We will donate that if we can come to an agreement where we might do some training at the campus, and we certainly engage in that. Those philanthropic organizations, those foundations that have an affinity for education, we're certainly having conversations with them and looking forward for their support. Looking to tap into that 8,500 base of alumni for Lunenburg campus, as well as our staff. So we'll be doing appeals for alumni as well as for our staff. I should note that our student association across the province made a decision last year that they would earmark $500,000 for the campaign. So our students who are currently at all of our campuses collectively over 5 years have said we will give $500,000. Even though they will not reap the benefit, they're paying it forward for future attendees. So we think that's a huge vote of confidence in what we are doing and what they believe the value of their education has been. We're looking at community partners who have had short and long-term relationships with, in particular, South Shore Regional Hospital Auxiliary have been so kind and gracious to us in the past, and they are certainly stepping up with maintaining their support for us. And then the communities we serve. Donations can be big, they can be small, they all make a difference when we're talking about some of that gap of success having the withdrawal, when we're not talking about a lot of money in some cases. So we have a gentleman from the Chester area, his name is Roger Mason. He has stepped up over the last year with a significant gift just because he wants to make a difference. And make a difference for youth in particular. So we're very pleased with that type of support. There is one slide that has a picture of the CCA student. And it gives you a few numbers. Last year we gave out over $52,000 in scholarships and bursaries at Lunenburg campus. The urgent aid, those types of one-off scenarios where a student might have to consider withdrawing, we gave it almost $6,000. We are trying to make sure that we do not turn anyone away who comes with a need for that short-term emergency help. We had 26 students who actually took advantage of that urgent aid. And then one of the things that we're very proud of is that 92% of our grads live and work in Nova Scotia. So we feel that we're contributing to the economy. We feel that we're helping to serve a need that where there is a definite skill shortage, and certainly the demographics go to that effect, where we need to have everybody engaged, either in a highly skilled or in a lesser skilled. And you know, we do trades, we do health and human services programming, we do business programming, and then we also do programming to get people ready to go into one of those programs. So if you haven't completed your high school diploma, you can come to NSCC to do that as well. How can you help? And I think that's the last piece that I want to talk about. I'm challenging you, each of you, to be an ambassador for Nova Scotia Community College. We've been sharing this news about our campaign. Now that you have some of that information, we want you to keep your minds open, keep your ears open if you're having a conversation in our community that you think might be mutually beneficial. We're always looking for advice. We're always looking for feedback. We've had some great community meetings to get a sense of, are we on the right track? What do we need to do? And how can we better serve our community? We will be having some breakfast events coming up over the next few months. I will make sure that you get invitations to come to those. I think it's very powerful when an organization like the Chamber can be seen to be at those types of events because they see a benefit, and we're all in this together to support our community to continue to thrive and grow. Visit the campus. Contact me, contact Blair. I don't know how many people have actually been to Lunenburg campus recently, but come and take a look around. You might be pleasantly surprised about what you see. And then we might want to engage you in strategic conversations. Are there individuals in the community? Are there organizations in our community that you feel I should be talking with, that my committee should be speaking with in order to make some connections? Maybe there's a critical need for training that they have, or maybe they would be interested in saying, you know, we believe in what the NSCC is doing, we want to support. So we really look that this is a good community building event for us. We think that this could be a game changer for students who come, who do not stay because of financial hardship, or the real tragedy would be do not see themselves as potentially being able to come to Nova Scotia Community College because of the financial hardship that they and their family might be facing. So if we can change that story, if we can change the lives of some of our youth, equally as important as some of those adults who might be disengaged now from the economy, from the workforce, to get them back into being feeling that they're making a difference in the world, then that's equally as important. We do have some wonderful partners, and I'm looking at Sean Saltwire as one of our partners to help spread the word. We're very appreciative of that. And so there's the financial aspect, but there's also the income. So getting the word out is a huge part of this as well. If you have any questions, be happy to answer any of those.
I have a couple.
Yep.
So this campaign's already started. Of the 350 that you're trying to raise locally, how much have you already raised?
We're about 70 in.
70,000 already. And how long have you started?
We started, the launch was in October. And for Bob, for everyone's benefit, Bob and Dan and I spoke in November, I think it was. So we're really starting to hit the ground now since the holidays.
Well, we had a conversation there about what you get for being involved, and besides the social aspects of doing something worthwhile, the business usually likes to get something out of it too. So on behalf of my company, the Home Center, I'd like to donate $500 towards the cause, and particularly the one to benefit the urgent aid ones. That's
great.
When you told me that story, it struck me the most.
Yeah.
So if you'd let me know who I make the check out to from the Home Center, then I'd be interested in participating that far, and I know the Chamber's going to want to participate in helping in any events that we can be involved in, as well as being invited to those breakfasts.
Awesome.
Anybody else, go ahead if you have questions there. I just wanted to...
Thank you, Bob.
Wow.
I have a comment, so it's less of a question, but I the urgent aid thing, I think that's fantastic. You know, I personally know a single mom who's 38, she's got four kids, she works, and she goes to school full time, and when she graduates this year of her 2-year diploma, it's going to be life changing for her and her kids. And she was one of those people who received some urgent aid last year. She had a vehicle mishap, she lives outside of town, and I thought it was really a great program for her. So it's good to see those dollars,
you don't know the benefit, for that that individual. Is not only her, it's her children.
And absolutely.
Setting that that example of, and I know that parents have said, I'm going to go home tonight and we're going to sit around the kitchen table, we're going to do our homework together. Now, how powerful is that to say that education is important? And thank you for that, Emily. That's a good story.
Anybody else have any questions or comments? Well, we want to thank you for coming and making the presentation today. Sorry to make you wait so long to get at the podium there. So I was fortunate. I had two kids that didn't go to university, went to community college, so it saved me a ton of money. So, and they're able to make a good living. So it was a great thing for us to be able to send somebody, and plus they got a couple of credits towards a degree if they ever do decide to go further. So
and there's probably nobody in this room that hasn't been touched or knows.
Yeah.
I mean, my wife graduated from NSCC, and she was hired by Capital Health before she even graduated.
Yeah. We have a lot of stories like that. Yeah.
And my sister is a single mom with four kids at 38. I thought maybe you were talking about her, but she doesn't have a pair. Went back and got her high school education with NSCC, so I think it's a great cause, and I'm glad Saltwire's involved, and if I can be involved with anything locally, please let me know.
Awesome. Thank you.
Okay.